Hi, Daryl here. So this is my first Nissan Leaf recharge attempt. So I've just borrowed this Nissan Leaf here to take for a test drive, and I've driven up to New World in Otaki where there's the fast charger. So if you turn around, you're about to see there's a ChargeNet fast charger just here. You can see it reviewed in one of my other videos. So I'm just going to go through the process of recharging the Nissan Leaf and see how that goes for me. So I've made the first amateur mistake of opening up the bonnet instead of opening up the power charge port. So in the power charge ports here, you've got your two ports. Under the orange cover is your J1774. I hope that's what it's called. I always get those numbers confused. And over there, you've got your CHAdeMO connector. So to activate the charger, you have to plug the car in first and then activate the charger. So I'll just do that. Got a red light on there. I don't know if that means good or bad. So we'll see in a second. So hopefully that should activate. And it looks like we're ready to go. Just going to recharge to 80%, but only going to recharge it for a few minutes because that's the amount of time I've got. Looks like the magic's beginning. Now the car is on 25%, so that's what I was saying, 25 there. So 25%, and the other counting up number is the amount of time elapsed so far. So 10 seconds of charging and tiny amount of power transferred. Oh, the machine has quite an interesting audible buzz. And if we come around here, you can see the power. Let's see if this will work. There we go. See the kilowatts here. So this one's had. Now the smart power meter goes through a lot of different cycles. It's a three phase. You can see L1, L2, L3, three phase. Here's the test of the whole display. And 2.489 kilowatts have passed. And it's charging at 44.8 kilowatts. 44 or 43 kilowatts there. Up to 30% charge already. It's only been 1 minute and 31 seconds. Is that? No, that's 31%. Oh, that's 75 cents. Oh, this is confusing. It's got a combination of price and other aspects there. Oh, so I've got 1.2 kilowatts of power transferred so far. I'll pause the video for a minute and we'll come back in another minute or two. I'm just going to record the different screens as I go through the display so I can find out what they mean later. So it's at 42%. So I've only been plugged in 5 minutes. And we started at 25%. So it's the kilowatts per kilometer or kilometers per kilowatt. 43. That must be the average consumption, kilometers per hour. No, average speed driven. So it's only been driven in a city pretty slow. I'm gonna guess. I don't know what these mean. This is always the fun with New Zealand, buying all these import cars from Japan. The other import fun is that the GPS just gives you these nonsense maps of somewhere else in the world, which are pretty much useless, and other information doesn't make a heck of a lot of sense either. I think I might unplug the car soon, because really I've picked up way more Ks faster than I kind of thought I would, so that's the point. It's meant to be a fast charger. So this number going up is kilometers left to drive, so you can kind of see that it's only taking a few seconds to increase the range drivable by each kilometer. Anyway, that's more than enough kilometers to get back, and I've got a limit on time. You can see the lights, the charging lights on the dash here. There's these three LEDs, and you can see that it's partially charged and increasing its charge. Okay, so for this charge, I've been plugged in for 8 minutes now and used $3 odd of charge and picked up 4 kilowatts. So to get 20 kilowatts, I'd have to be in here for 5 times at lunchtime. 8 fives are 40 minutes. So I've picked up 5 kilowatts in 10 minutes and it's cost less than $4. So that's interesting. I'll be able to do some calculations to see the practicability of that. So now I'm going to go ahead and stop the charge. And to stop the charge, you can see that the charger is locked here. It's showing locked. And to unlock it, I have to unlock it with my special key tag again. So there we go, unlock. And now I can stop. And it's the charging process stop. So that's shut down the charger. And now I should be able to just disconnect. It's saying disconnect and hang up the charger. So I'll go ahead and do that. Oh, it's got a little unlock in there, so it shows green, and then when you press the button, it goes unlock. There we go, and now the charge is set for the next person to use it. And all I have to do is close the charge port. I never had to have the orange one open, but there we go, done. And then close that, and I have to close the hood. But first I'm going to have a look in here. It looks real clean, the ventilation pump's still on. And there was something to look at, oh, under those covers. Have a look at that later. It's one of those beautiful sunny autumn afternoons. Now I've got up to 71 kilometers, so that was interesting. I'll have to just check what the range and numbers and everything were, and then I'll do a drive down the highway back to drop the car back off. I recharged the car from 25% up to almost 60%, and that 60% is forecasting 71 kilometers of range. So that will be to tell me something about how much distance I can use. So now I'm going to get into that drive back. I didn't bring with me a holder for my phone, so I can't really record any video while I'm driving, but I'm going to drive down the new expressway, which is a nice new motorway. So most of the trip will be at 70, then 100, then back to 70 for the transition, then back to 100 kilometers per hour, then back to 50 for the last bit. So a bit of a combined, but mostly the kind of drive that you'd do if you're doing a commute on a highway. So we'll see how that goes. It was all in all pretty good test drive. I learned quite a lot of stuff about what the sort of average expected driving range would be, and I've made a spreadsheet, so you'll see that coming up shortly. There were some things that were not so great. The GPS never shows any useful information, So although it has a GPS with maps, every Japanese car I've ever driven has never had a base map that includes the whole world. So all you see is pieces of Japan. It must have some terrible rounding algorithm that shows you a location that is of no use at all. And also, ChargeNet sends really excellent text messages. They send a message at the start of charging and at the end of charging, and it tells you the state of your battery and how much power you picked up and what the cost was. So that was very good. I didn't know that they did that. And then I made the spreadsheet, which tries to show what my guess for the calculation of the expected range of this particular car would be. And this would probably be pretty typical of a Nissan Leaf with 10 bars. And then this was a calculation where I tried to work out how much it would cost to recharge the car for 5 hours or 10 hours and how much power you would get and what the cost of that would be. So the costs are in dollars. Thanks for watching. Please like, subscribe, and comment. If you subscribe, you'll get the videos when they're fresh. I'm going to test drive another Nissan Leaf next week, and so I'll make a video about that as well. Thanks again for watching.